A little bit. I thought you were going to demonstrate leaping for apples. Clever girl. I didn't have any apples. You're doing a very good job of picking apples yourself. Yeah. You want me to pick apples for you, huh? Now, she's having a problem biting into this apple. Because she only has teeth on the bottom part of her mouth and her top part, the gums. So if I drop it on the floor, She can push it into the ground. There we go. So her bottom teeth are her cutting teeth. Is there a top of her mouth or gums? Uh-oh, competition now for the apple. Hey, beautiful. How are you? You want an apple? Here's an apple. You don't want an apple. Competition for the apple. Hanging out under the apple tree. Waiting for apples to fall. Life is so hard for some sheep. Isn't that right, LittleBit? You don't want strokes, you want apples. Competition for apples are fierce. Look, it's right there. Oh, Becky, you beautiful girl. LittleBit on the hunt for apples. You good man. You good old boy. Aren't you? Yeah. Here comes Ebony. Everybody's coming. Ever hopeful for some of these apples to fall. Pecking orders being established, re-established. Something that always happens in a flock. And I'm just having a nice conversation with Alfie. You good boy. Yeah. You good boy. How are you? How's Ebony? Alfie's asking Ebony if she's in season. I don't think Ebony is. The others are now waiting for LittleBit to knock an apple down. Let her do the work and then they'll bully her away from the apple. This is LittleBit and Ebony. Everybody's asking for attention. The other girls have abandoned the hope of apples. And Alfie's now having a good scratch on the apple tree. He might knock an apple down. Trying to get me to scratch her. Oh, you're such a pup of a sheep. Yeah.